There is a lot of magic happening in Canva. They just released some brand new features that will really help with your design process. These new features are all part of what's being called Magic Studio, and I'm going to break some of them down for you. My name is Kat. This is Canva Catterday. Let's get to it. The first new feature can be found right on the Canva homepage. You will see it says Meet Magic Studio. And right here you have this little magnifying glass with some sparkles. That's how you know you have the new update. If you don't have it just yet, don't worry because they are still rolling it out. You'll click right here in the search bar and you have a new option here that's going to allow Canva to create content for you in just a couple of seconds simply by you typing some search criteria. So it's giving you some suggestions right here, or you can type your own description of you what you want that to be, and Canva will then create that content. So I'm going to use one of these suggestions. I'll click this one right here, and Canva is going to create a lemonade poster for me. If you don't like it, you can change it. Click on category and pick a different type of content. So maybe you want a Facebook post. You're going to click Facebook post and it will automatically update. Now, just below that, you'll still see the other Canva templates that it's always had within the template library based on that size content that you're looking for. But here at the very top, it has Magic Design, and Canva has created these designs from scratch. Then you'll just click on one of them, add your favorite colors and update your fonts, maybe add some of your content like your pictures or videos in there, and you have a brand new design just like that. The next new feature is called Magic Design for Video. I am in just a blank vertical video template, like for a reel or a story. And you'll notice right here, it says generate videos instantly. So we are going to click on this option. And now it wants you to upload your content. I already have a few photos and videos here that I want to use. You can add up to 10 and Canva will put them together for you. And then it's going to ask you to describe the type of video that you want. So you're just going to give it some type of description. So let's put day in the life of an office cat, because I have office cats. And then I'm going to just click generate and Canva is going to create that content for me. Once it's done, you will see you have a series of slides with some text. Sometimes it's even got some animation. It's added transitions. It even added music for me. Now I'm going to play this, but I'm going to remove the music because it won't play at the same time that I'm recording. So I'm going to take the music out, but let me show you what this looks like. Here we go. It added these fun little transitions for me. It added the text. How fun is that? You can change this. You can change the font style and the colors. You can move things around. For instance, if I want all of this content to be down here, I can move that down here like that. I can leave that one where it is. We'll leave that one there. And then let's move this a little bit. Let's bring this more towards the center like that. And then you can replay it, play it again. It's just a really cool way to create video content. This is perfect if you want to create some reels or stories, if you've got some products and you want to put them all together in like a little video montage, but you don't quite know what you want to do. Let Canva do it for you by creating this content. And then obviously you can change the end screen to your branding or some type of call to action message. This is just a really great way to do that video content in just a few seconds without really having to think about it. Next up is Magic Presentation. So I'm just in a blank presentation template here. Up at the very top, once again, there's those little magic sparkles. I'm going to click on this and I have some suggestions. You can type whatever you want in here as far as a description. I'm just going to choose this one. Canva will generate that magic content for me. I'm going to click See All. Here we go. We've got a couple options. As you can see here, it's given me 7 slides that I can use for this content. So let's just go grab this one. I'm going to add all 7 slides and it just created that presentation for me. You can adjust this by adding your brand colors. Simply go over here to where it says styles and you can pick any of the colors that are in here, or you can add your own brand colors. You can even change the layout if you want like a different layout for it. But this is just really versatile as far as being able to create those presentations without you having to go through a lot of steps. You can just let Canva do it for you by just typing a few sentences or a few words in there, and it will automatically update that and create those presentation slides for you. Next, we're going to talk about something called Magic Switch. It's right here at the very top. This used to say Magic Edit. What they've done is they've taken Magic Edit and they've integrated it into this new method called Magic Switch. So let's take a look at this. We're going to click on Magic Switch. Right off the bat, you've got two brand new features. One is called Translate, which will allow you to take your content and translate it into another language. And the other one is called Transform to Doc. We'll look at that in just a second. Down here, you can still adjust this. Right now, this is a carousel image. I can change that to a different size or a different type of social media content. You can still add a size if you want to. You can also do it by category. So if you click social media, you can see there are some updates for social media here, as well as some additional options down in the drop-down list to resize that content. And then all you'll do is click on that, and then you have a choice to change the existing content or create brand new content from that new size. But let's go over here to Transform into Doc. This is what's brand new. You've got the option to do all of these really cool things. You can create a summary, make it all text, make it a blog post, an email, a poem, and yes, even song lyrics. This one cracks me up. Let's say I want to take this carousel and I want to turn it into a blog post, but I don't want to retype everything myself. I can let Canva do it for me. I'm going to click blog post. I'm going to click transform into doc, and Canva is going to convert this into a blog post. Depending on how many images or pages you have in this content will determine how long it takes. If you have a lot of them, it may take a little bit. So just be patient and let it do its thing. Otherwise, it'll probably just do it in a couple of seconds. So I'm going to click on this and it's going to update the design for me. Once it's done, you can click where it says Open Doc. It will open a brand new document with that blog layout, just like that. It even embellished a little bit and added some more content to it. If you don't like what it says, you can always change it, or you can also have it rewrite it. For instance, maybe I don't like this text that's right here. I can just click on this, click Magic Write, and I can continue writing, I can summarize a text, I can rewrite it, add more fun, make it more formal, whatever you want it to do, because now it's actually a Canva doc. But this makes it so easy to take any of your content and convert it for another social media platform. Magic Animate is what's next. I have a few slides right here and I can animate them. Now there were other animation tools right down here. You've got combinations and basics, but what Magic Animate does is it will combine different effects for you all together. So you don't have to do it on your own manually. So click Magic Animate and it will give you some suggestions. You can do bold, you can do playful, handmade. You can pick any one of these combinations. And once you choose it, it'll update it and even add those transitions for you. So let's choose this one. Right here, it's automatically updated. Here's my transitions in between my pages. And let's see what this looks like. You can see it added my text. It's bringing it in a different way with each slide, and it even added those transitions to my document. So this one's really versatile. If you have some static images or a static post and you want to turn it into an animation, you can use this new Magic Animate feature as well. Let's dig into a couple of the new apps. The first one is called Magic Morph. To find it, you want to go over to the apps in the sidebar and then scroll down until you see this green logo right here that says Magic Morph. We're going to click that. You're simply going to pick some text or an element that's on your page and then give it a description of what you want it to look like. So for instance, I have this star element right here. You can see it's selected and I want to turn this into a gold foil balloon. I'm going to click Magic Morph. It's going to give me a couple of options. Anytime you're using one of the magic transition effects or the magic morph or magic edit effects, it will usually give you four options to choose from. Here are my four options, and I can pick any one of these to add it to my design. Let's choose this one. It will add to my design. I'm going to move this up here, and I don't need this placeholder image anymore. There you go. That's Magic Morph. This also works on text. I will caution not to use text that's really thin. It kind of has mixed results. So make sure that the font that you're using is like nice and big and bold, or something that's on the heavier side. That seems to work best with this. Otherwise, it kind of gets a little bit lost. The next app we're going to talk about is called Magic Media. It's this one right here, Magic Media. Text to image isn't new. It was introduced last year, but what they did add was the ability to do text to videos. So for text to image, you would simply type in whatever criteria you want it to be, and Canva would generate an AI image. Well, now it works on videos. Now, I currently don't have this option available in my account. It is still being rolled out, but basically you would simply click on that option, and here's a generated image right here that Canva has already created. You simply type your text, and it will generate a video image for you now as well. So you can use text to image or text to video. One really important thing I do want to point out, there are limitations with this when you're using this option. So if you plan on using this text to image feature, you do have some limits. If you're on the free Canva account, you have 50 uses for the life of your Canva account. If you're on a paid account or an education account, you have 500 uses per month. And then for video, you only have 5 lifetime uses on a free account. And if you're a paid account, you have 50 uses per month. And at the end of that month, that rolls over. This is a Canva Pro feature, as are a lot of these new magic features. They are pro features. So if you want to try out Canva Pro, you can click the link in the description. You can get a 30-day free trial. I highly recommend it because these brand new features they've updated are really, really special. Everything in Magic Studio is so cool, so you can go check that out for yourself. We are going to work with some magical updates with images now. The first one is called Magic Expand. I'm going to click on this image, click Edit Photo. You will see a bunch of new magical features right here. Background Remover and Magic Eraser rolled out not too long ago, but you now have Magic Expand, Edit, which has been improved. It does a lot better now. Magic Grab and Grab Text. So we are going to work with Magic Expand right now. Sometimes you have an image and it doesn't fully cover what you're trying to work with. For instance, I have this flower photo and it doesn't fully cover the entire size of my design. Yes, you can drag the handles and stretch the image, but if you don't want to do it that way, if you want the whole image, you can use this Magic Expand feature and the AI will then fill in those gaps. So let's click Magic Expand. You've got some options here for how you want that size to be. I want it to be the whole page, so I'm going to click on this, and Canva will then try to generate the rest of the image for me. Click Expand. It generated 4 suggestions. This first one is not too bad. This is the first one it's suggested, but if you don't like that, you can pick one of the others. So let's go look at this one. That one gets a little blurry on the edges. Not really like that one. That one's not bad. That one's okay. And that one's not bad as well. I think I like this first one. Once you've chosen, you're just going to simply click done and it will add that to your design. It is a little hit or miss sometimes. There are some images that produce less than favorable results. So you may want to just play with this one a little bit until you get the exact result that you're looking for. The next new editing effect is called Grab Text. So I have this photo that has text that's already embedded within the photo. We're going to click Edit Photo, and I'm going to click Grab Text, and Canva's actually going to isolate this text for me so that it's editable. So you click Grab Text. Canva will then suggest a font for you to use. Now you can see right here on this one, it sort of blends that font into the background. I'm going to change this real quick and make it all white so that we can see it. There we go. It will always add some suggested fonts. You can change these to whatever you want them to be. And I'm going to adjust this a little bit. But here is our original. And here is the updated version. And because these are now actual text boxes, we can change and edit them. We can change what they say. And you can even change the font by picking a different font style or even changing the size if you want to. Just makes it really easy if you have text that's already on that image and you want to change it to make it say something else. The last new Canva feature is my favorite of all of these new updates, and it's called Magic Grab. It is so, so cool. Click on Edit Photo right here where it says Magic Grab. What Canva is going to do is isolate the subject from the background. I love this one. Let me show you. You're going to click on that. You can see Canva automatically puts a little box around the subject, and then you can put the subject wherever you want on the page. This one is so much fun, especially if you do anything where you have maybe a product and you want to add some text, or you could even use it for something like YouTube thumbnails. Maybe you have an image that you really like, but the subject or the object that's in those photos, it's not exactly in the place you want it to be. You can use this new feature, Magic Grab, to isolate that subject and put the subject in a different location. You can even duplicate it, move it somewhere else, maybe add some fun little effect like flipping it around like that. You can do some really neat things with this. What else I like about this, though, that I'm really, really excited about is a lot of times when I am searching for images in Canva, I usually gravitate towards things that have like nice backgrounds to them. What this also does, not only can you isolate the subject, you can remove the subject entirely if you don't want it within your image. So here I've isolated that subject, and yes, I can move it to a different location, but I can also delete it so that I just have the background image. This is going to completely change the way people look at the images in Canva because now they have a dual purpose. You can have the original image, or you can take that image, remove the subject from it, and now you have a brand new background that you can use for something entirely different. For instance, this one right here, I'm going to grab that image out of there, Magic Grab. I can move her or I can delete her entirely. Let's go do one more. I've got this right here. This is a little cafe. I like the cafe, but maybe I want to change the cup to something else. So I'm going to click on the image, click Edit Photo, click Magic Grab, and I simply delete the cup from the image. It's just so much fun. I would love to know which of these new features you like. So tell me down in the comments below, which one of these features will you use the most? Which one of these has you most excited? I would love to get your feedback on that. If this was helpful, be sure to hit the subscribe button so you can see my videos in the future. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.